I don't want the people to see this happening.
Okay.
I want to zoom in on the guitar player with this same screen up here.
Mm-hmm.
And then once I get zoomed in to where I want on the guitar player, then I'm going to transition to him.
Okay. So let me go ahead and get him set. Let's say he's right there.
Mm-hmm.
Now let's go to number 2, auto. And zoom both of them.
Okay. Now that shot that was just on there,
got a tree
there. I want it to go, say, to the bass player.
Well,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I see.
If these two screens is up here, and they look, and all they're going to see is the finished transition. They're not going to see me working with
you. Yeah. Yep.
Does it do that?
Yeah, what we'll do is we'll set presets. So you see that one's still on there.
Yep.
Okay, so what you would need to... There's a couple ways you could do this. The easiest way would be... Keep your bass player. What am I doing?
But see, I'll be switching them all night long to different ones.
Right.
Let's say your bass player is going to be...
Because Jimmy every now and then, he throws his leg up in there when he's playing. We won't catch that.
Let's say he's right there.
Mm-hmm.
So the way to set a preset is you're going to do set preset 1. So literally you'll point it at the camera. On this side for this camera, set preset 1. You'll see up in the left-hand corner there. Mm-hmm. All right, now let's zoom out on Jimmy or whoever that is there. Now let's say we want to go over here to
this guy in his chair.
This guy in right. the chair.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we don't want to get in his crotch there, but we want to get up above his head. Oh man, come on, man.
Well, the chair is him there.
Yeah.
With the guitar, yeah.
So
okay.
There we go. All right. So now we'll literally do the same exact thing.
Preset.
Point at the camera. Set. Preset 2. And it shows up in the corner. All right. So now let's just zoom out completely as if we was going to leave it right there for now. And let's go back to this camera, which will be number 2. All right. So I'm going to set this one right there for everybody to see. Alright, so now I want to go to the bass player.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to take my preset number 1, which is right here. I'm going to point it at that camera, and I just push preset number 1.
Preset number
just,
1.
You just hit 1.
I just hit number 1.
Preset number 1.
And if I push the right button here, there it is.
Okay.
Okay.
Now which button did you just now press?
Auto.
Auto, okay.
Auto
gotcha.
Cuts. Yeah, we
gotcha. All right.
We went... So now we're back to that one. Okay, let's say we want to not show everybody, but we're going to go over here to the chair.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to take number 2. We're going to point it at that camera. We're going to hit push number 2.
Right camera.
And now let's see if it works. We're at number 2.
Okay, now if he was off just a tad, you could
take your...
And I just pointed it at the camera.
You could go boom, boom. I mean...
Can you slow down those movements?
Okay. I've got the same camera at my church, and I wish for that every Sunday.
Yeah, that's a good point. Yeah,
I wish you could, but you. Mm-mm. They may do an update later, but as of right now.
The one I was watching that picture in the picture, you can actually make those screens bigger.
Yep, and that's something you can go in here.
But you can't save it once you go out of it.
You can take that picture in picture and make it this big.
Yeah.
But that's something that I don't know if you want to do that. You know, that's one of those things that...
It'd be like if he was playing somebody was...
Yeah, you could do a 2-shot. And that picture in picture should be... Let's see. Yeah. So say you wanted a preview.
The band's still playing, but we're going to go ahead.
We're going to show this. You can press number 2, which will be this camera. So that way you've got 2 feeds. You've got the guy in the chair, and you've got the full view. Let's say we want
Can I drag him on now? Let's show me how to make him bigger.
To make him like the picture, or
yeah, just make the picture in picture. I want to get bigger, like this right here.
So that should be
with the full band playing.
Okay, let's see.
Not we ever gonna do it, but it'd be nice to know.
Yeah,
well, you see better too, you know. What you got there, yeah.
Let's go back here.
But you most definitely need to let him get in here and play with it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's definitely the best way to.
Yeah, get in here and just, you know, if you don't mind, Eric, you and your wife or whoever, get in here and he'll give you the key and lock the door, don't let nobody in. And just get in here.
The door's charging $5. We're going to do something.
Well, if they won't watch you do it, yeah, charge them
$10. We're going to do something.
Yeah.
That's the best way to learn, because see, he knows what he's doing, but you got to learn what he's doing.
You just got to find where it's at.
Right.
Everything's a little bit different.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, I'm trying to find the picture in the picture. Mr. Dalton does the picture in the picture, and Mr. Dalton is not feeling well.
Well, I seen a video. I go back and watch it again, and the guy was showing me about, you know, how to do that, and also.
Oh, there it is. What am I doing? Duh. Or is that? I thought that was it. I may be wrong. Well, that's how you get rid of it. You can capture a still picture, which is number one. Let's say you want to go over to number two, you capture another still. Now you've got two stills. I just don't know where the picture in the picture.
That's where you can add that on there. You can type in at the bottom of the screen. Like, you can put Don's name on there. And then when he's singing, it'll come up and have his name on the bottom of the screen. And then you can fade it out.
In and out, yeah. Right.
Or you can have popcorn, special popcorn.
Yeah.
Shit.
That's audio. Hang
on. As we go, we'll learn, we'll pick up more and more.
As you go.
We'll get the basics down.
We got to have a... have to be ready by. We're going to do a show December the 5th.
You could put the deadline on it. This year?
I've got a group that's coming.
But the main thing he needs to learn how to do is to make sure he knows that you're going to record the show in case something goes. At least you got it recorded.
Yeah.
How to do that, right? Done?
No, we ain't got to that part.
Yeah, that's what
it'll bank up to
15 that's a backup.
Shows.
See, that's be a backup. You can go in there and edit it.
I got to get a larger external hard drive if I'm going to save more than 15. This will save 15.
Did it say 15 shows? Mm-hmm. Oh, well, great. Yeah, but you need to make sure you know how to record the show.
Okay, pay this no attention, because this is actually, this is the Blackmagic cameras. Mm-hmm. You don't have Blackmagic cameras. You've got data video cameras. So if you had a Blackmagic camera, you could go in here and you could go and you can move it with the mouse. We're just not a huge fan of Blackmagic cameras. So don't pay the camera button down here any attention at all. You can, like, literally I wouldn't even ever click on that, because you can sit here and drag this mouse pad around here all day long.
So you never click on what now? What is it?
The camera. Over there. Yeah.
Oh, never click on
it
the
only,
camera. Okay.
It only really works for their cameras. And you, like I said, you've got data video cameras. So let's go back. I'm still trying to find the picture in the picture thing, and Braden, you may have to help me out with that one.
Did he work on the sound? Did he get the sound?
Yeah, so I would highly recommend not having ambient mics in-house, because that thing you heard, it started feedbacking. Mm-hmm. So
what good are they?
They're just for like the live stream sound.
Surround sound. Surround sound.
It would be really hard to get these mics and sound system to work with the ambient mics in house.
Yeah, they're just like a backup system.
So yeah.
I've got one at my church.
I mean, we can plug it again in a minute. I'll show y'all.
That's what sometimes when we're doing wedding, I use one of them mics and it'll pick up the pastor, the bride and the groom, get them walking around.
Mm-hmm. I've got one in my church, and I call it my crowd mic. It just pretty much, the only reason I use it for is to pick up the noise, I guess you could say, the noise that's around. If somebody drops their book on the floor, you actually, you know, you kind of get to hear it. It makes your live stream more, live, as he says. I mean, it's not hard. You never could find.
You take just old plain mono recording and use ambient sound on it.
I sound like stereo. I looked that up. I got a beat.
Apologize for that, but it's, I don't know, for some reason that's not coming up on here for some reason.
So actually, you don't, that where he's got that right there, you don't really need, you can do it all from this
from
little
right
box.
Here.
Yep, from right there. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, have one about where you can add media to it. Your own graphics and stuff.
Which was where I was, but for some reason, I'm not completely familiar with it myself here. I know the basics. So let's see. Let's get you on YouTube here. Let's get you going live. And let's get you on to the web page here. So we're gonna come in and the night of or the day of, we're gonna go to YouTube. We're gonna go YouTube and up here, I'm gonna make this bigger. Up here, we're going to make sure that we're on our page. We're going to make sure that we're on Brazil's Bluegrass. Make sure that you're actually, this is your page. Sometimes YouTube can log you out. It's very, very rare, but sometimes if they go like through an update or something, they'll log you out. So if you're coming in here, you're on YouTube, you're on your page, you want to go live, you're going to go to Create. You're going to see a little camcorder button right here. Yeah, a little tab will pop down. You'll push go live.
Create and then go live.
Yep. And right now, we need to set up your encoder. This is something that we need to do. You won't have to do this. You can watch us do it, but this is something that we're going to have to do really quick before we can actually go into the streaming button, because you still had, when we was here the last time, you had the 24-hour window that YouTube was locking you out of. So we gotta set that up for you.
So he's gonna set that up for you.
Say it one more time.
BG Bluegrass Cafe.com.
Cafe.
C-A-F-E.
C-A-F-E.
.com.
.com. All right, I got it for you.
All right, here we go. So let's, we've gotten in now, so we're gonna go into.
All right.
Let's, if you don't mind, pull me some music up on here. If you can log into there for us, while he's logging in, what we'll do is the night of, you're coming in, you're gonna go over here to your Black OBS Studios. You'll double click it. It will pull up. Thank you, sir. And okay, so you'll go in here and you will go over here. You'll see your preview. You go to start streaming.
Start streaming. Okay.
You'll push it.
Push it. All right.
And that will directly start your stream. To double check, you can go into Google Chrome.
You mean to see if you're online?
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay.
You go to YouTube, create, go live, and it should be going live here.
Well, you can also have you have another phone out.
Yes, sir.
I believe I'd do that. Just have another phone instead of going through all that.
Yep.
Just go to your phone.
Oh, so you don't have to really go to that.
No, just go.
Check it on your phone. He's phone. Got it on his phone right
there. Yeah, and that way, just do it like that right there.
Let's send audio to it.
Yes. Okay. Didn't put Brazil's grocery bluegrass.
Right.
It changed it on one of them, but it didn't change it on this one.
Hit edit.
There you
what
go.
What's yours say?
The old bluegrass. Grocery. Well, here it says Brazil's grocery bluegrass. The channel name is
right. Yeah, just go live on your phone.
That's right. Forget it.
That's all he's doing there, just making sure. It's
making sure, yeah. Yep. But the
and
safe.
If it's not working.
Audio.
Yeah.
Check audio here. Audio's there. Yeah. Let me check audio here.
See, I'm just the audio's literally at the bottom, okay?
Checking audio. Still no audio.
I'm up here, I'll go outside with myself on my headphones, and I'll be out there telling you what's going on. So I'll help you there on that. Or your wife can do that too. And once you get it on,
that's good.
Go up, look away from the building, put your headphones that way, you know what everybody else is hearing all over the world.
That's what we're
going to
use your headphones.
Right. It's best to go outside the building. Get away from everything, and where you can hear what's going on. Yeah, and that's what I did.
And then you can mix it
right
on bus one.
Right, bus one. Mm-hmm.
There's not.
It's in to the ATM software. He just found out. Yeah, thank you, sir. I just turned the audio off. This is your main audio right here. Underneath your streaming platform. So when you're streaming, you're going to bring this up into the yellow, and that will make sure you bring your audio up. You got some clipping going on right here. You need to turn that down a little bit. You'll probably never really have to.
That's the desktop audio right there.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. And that's your mix aux audio.
Okay, that's what we mixed over here off the bus one.
Yes, sir. But I would mix it off of here. Mix off of here. Mm-hmm. Go into here. And then you're streaming from here. You still got audio? And there's going to be a delay. There's going to be a 20-second delay, probably. So we'll see. Let's see if these work in here now.
Okay, stop stream. What'd you do now?
Stop stream. I'm going to redo it one more time.
Okay, all right, here we go.
So
start
I'm
going to
exile.
Can you bring the volume down?
Cut your volume.
Yeah. All right.
We'll bring it back up to make sure that it works here in just a second.
Okay,
all right. And okay, so we've started from scratch. So mm-hmm. we're going to come in.
Okay, going to come in.
We have opened up OBS Studio.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so we've got that open. Mm-hmm. We're going to go ahead and we're going to open up our ATM software.
ATM software. Mm-hmm.
Which is basically the same thing we've got here.
All right.
We're going to minimize it. And I'm also going to pull up YouTube so I can see a preview when I want to here. You can also pull up YouTube on your phone if you want to.
That's what I would do. Have one going, yeah.
You can either pull it up on your phone, you can pull it up on here, however you want to do it. You'll go to create, you'll go to go live. It'll pop up. And if you are not streaming yet, you will not see anything. It'll just come up as this. You won't see it. You'll go down here to your OBS Studio, which is the black icon. You'll go down here to start streaming.
Mm-hmm.
You'll push start streaming.
Mm-hmm.
It'll start.
Okay. Now, once you get online live, can you pause the live? In other words, that might not be ready to go on to show. Can you pause it some way? So once you go on live, you're live.
You can show
you're live. So remember
sponsors.
That.
You can show the sponsors. You can go to.
Oh, you can show the preview of the sponsors. Okay.
So when you go, you got to go to YouTube and hit live before anything's going
to happen. Yeah.
Yeah.
But what I'm saying, once you go live though, you live. Be ready to go with the show.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I point the camera towards something and play music in the background.
Are you sponsors?
As you can see, we are live with the sponsors right now.
What I'm saying, if you ain't got your sponsors ready to go, just have something playing.
Yeah.
Oh, but unless you just want to show the crowd, you know, with them sitting around talking. Yeah.
And
all right.
You can
and then,
see them.
So now, what's next?
Okay.
Once you get on.
So a good thing to do is pre-record opening thing, a preview. Like welcome.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Check out, and you just show the same one. And you just show that feed when it starts.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And then
that's a good idea.
Out, and then you could go have your commercials, and we'll be right back after
see that?
This.
Yeah.
See
and
that?
Then,
you got some good
ideas. Then you
that's
got
it.
Time to get everybody ready to go.
Ready to go.
Again.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
All right. So, say you just went through an hour-long concert here. You're
mm-hmm.
ready to end it.
Okay, end it. Here we go. We're going to end it, folks. Here we go.
You're going to go into your black OBS software that you started from.
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to go to stop streaming. Right
this
here
is stop
the one
streaming.
That's highlighted in gray.
All right.
It'll go through. You're off the air.
Mm-hmm.
To double check it, you can either look on your phone or you can go over here. And it'll start circling.
Mm-hmm.
And to absolutely make sure that you are stopped streaming, you can go up there and push end stream.
Right.
Like right there, you could, when you end that, you can click and have your ending credits or whatever.
Yes.
Right, there you go.
Exactly.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Now.
What happens, say, I go over here and I hit start streaming, and I didn't do nothing with YouTube, what would happen?
It would start.
YouTube would start.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't have to go to YouTube and start.
Mm-hmm. YouTube is just
a
monitor. That's just a personal monitor preference. That's if it was me, I'd go on YouTube just to make sure.
Okay, but all jokes aside, I don't have to go to YouTube at all.
No, sir.
Mm-hmm. It's just my own check.
OBS is
start,
where you start.
Start and stop.
Yep, OBS,
mm-hmm.
start, and then same button to stop.
Okay,
it.
Now when show starts and I want to show opening thing he's got over here, we'd have a little icon on this computer over here on your right,
mm-hmm.
and it would be like opening credits. I click that video and it comes up and it has down the bottom to play it, you know, like a MegPeg 4.
Yeah.
And then I hit start MegPeg 4, then I hit Auto 3, and it's gone. Whatever's playing on that computer
mm-hmm.
would start showing that video.
Exactly.
Right.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Now, do you know how to record the show in case you mess up and don't get to record it?
That's what he said.
Yeah, if you can record it, that's the main thing you want to get. Yeah. Make sure you record
it. He wants
it.
To so save them.
That records
save
them. It.
Save your show.
Yeah.
Oh, so it's going. It's whatever we do in live stream. It's recording.
It records
right?
It. It should. He'll have to show you that.
Okay, so that is pretty much the same exact thing here. We'll record it.
This is recording.
As if you was going to start your stream, which let's start our stream one more time. We're starting stream. We're live on YouTube right now.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to go right below start stream to start record.
So hit that.
Yes, sir.
That's all you got to do all
and
through the show.
It's on there now.
How about the end? You got the end record, or does it do by itself?
A little bit of music.
Does it? How would you start record?
Same thing.
You have to click on record again. That ends it.
Yes.
Now, what would you save? What file would you save it under?
It should save under its own file. Let's see where it saves.
See if you can find out what file in there. Well, you know where to find it.
Let this go for about a minute. And if you look down here very closely, you can see your live stream has been going for 44 seconds, and your record has been going for 40 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so let's stop our live stream.
And record keeps going.
Let's let record go to a minute.
Right.
We're at 56 seconds, 57, 58, 59, boom. We just quit our recording at a minute.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Now let's go to streaming recording. Nope. Pause that for just a minute, because I'm not sure where I'm going to. I'm going to be completely honest with you. Where's Dalton?
Probably look under files.
No, look under files. That's it.
I would automatically save it under videos.
Yes, sir. And we can listen to it, I think. Yep.
Now I wanted to give that a date.
You want to give that a date?
Yeah, say this is going to be
whatever the day the show was.
Yeah, yeah. So that way we can some notes or something.
Yeah.
It did.
I guess
date
you just go back to that folder.
It dated it right there. Yeah, it put what time it was, what year.
If you double click on that, then you can just, mm-hmm, like any other folder.
Mm-hmm. You can play it. And you can, of course, speak.